never play, but you never want to lose.
So there it was, the same melody as the Find It All. Same melody as that. But what he did was he brought it down as opposed to going up, comes down, which makes this really beautiful diminuendo in the sound. Interesting choice. Okay, so he definitely changed it up there. I like that he was ambitious and that he tried to change it up. There's a little bit of a lack of smoothness to it.
Run, run, lost boy, they say to me.
Hey everyone, my name's Adam Michan. I'm a singer, songwriter, and vocal coach. And today we're going to be reacting to one of my favorite bands from my high school days. I was really into rock at the time. Tool, System of a Down. So we're going to be doing System of a Down, Aerials. Beautiful song. Let's check it out. I love that bass intro. Not many songs are driven by a bass guitar right at the beginning. It's very rare.
We lose ourselves, but we find it all.
So that was really awesome. So what you're hearing there is a bit of he's Serge. He's got a bit of an operatic feel to his vocal. He likes to sing with a lowered larynx a lot, and it kind of gives it that robust, rounded vibe. He usually, in these songs, sings more of the lower parts, then the guitarist sings the higher parts. So for this part, he's hanging out in that lowered larynx position until he sings all. Swimming through the void. So he's got that lowered larynx. Find. Low larynx. It all. So for all, raises the larynx. All. And it kind of adds in that little at the end, which is a bit of a cry. Kind of tells you that his vocal cords were compressing as he was singing that part. So that's kind of what he's doing in that part. Overall, keeping the larynx low, right for all, allowing his larynx to come up a little bit, and adding in a really beautiful vibrato, which adds in, like, not many rock singers are singing with tons of vibrato. So that adds to the bit of the operatic feel in his vocal.
If you want to see an uncut version of this video, check out the link in the description.
Always wanna go, but you never wanna stay.
And so there you could hear the guitarist on the upper harmony, and their voices blend so, so beautifully because he's got that operatic feel that is much more rounded, warm, robust. And then the guitarist has a little bit more of a higher pitched, not like bright, brassy, rock type of vibe. And so the two coming together just makes this beautiful harmony.
If you want to get a free lesson from me, click the link down below.
Always wanna play, but you never wanna lose.
So there it was, the same melody as the Find It All. Same melody as that, but what he did was he brought it down as opposed to going up, comes down, which makes this really beautiful diminuendo in the sound. Always wanna play, but you never wanna lose. Coming down to that lower part where he diminuendo much quieter, settling into his lowered larynx position. Beautiful, beautiful setup for the next verse.
You're alive. Life is a waterfall.
So interesting. Now the chorus is changing as opposed to the verse. That is very rare. A repeat verse and then a little bit of some different wording. Like the overall feel is the same, but a word here and there is changing, which is totally unique.
Ourselves, but we find it all.
And so you could hear that same approach again. Lowered larynx to higher larynx. Nice vibrato on the top.
Always wanna go, but you never wanna stay.
Beautiful harmony. Oh, it's just gorgeous.
Oh, oh.
Ah, so amazing. So there you could hear that it's like that robust operatic feel coming in with a little bit of a rock vibe. It's so nice to hear. I love how he leans into that with so much fullness. More of a rounded sound. Not that was too bright. Oh, it's like got a little bit more of that. Oh. Love it. I mean, I'm not doing it justice at all, but just trying to get into the feel of what he's doing. Drums are amazing. They really don't make music like this anymore.
When you free your eyes, you burn.
And so there you have a nice chorus effect between their two vocals, just using the qualities to create some sort of difference between the two. And you can very clearly hear the separation between their two vocals.
Aerials in the sky.
And you can hear this nice round. Aerials. Got that really warm roundness to it. Aerials. Beautiful.
So up
Man, that gives me shivers. Just pure breath. Like, it's a pure whisper. So up Just a nice breath to that. Gorgeous. Totally not pitched at all. And that's perfectly fine because it's a pure style point. Now you can hear them both doing a little bit more of an operatic feel, lower larynx. Oh, it's got a little bit more of that lower larynx position as he's doing it. And you can even hear in the guitarist's voice. Oh, it's got a little bit of that. This beautiful cymbal sound that kind of goes with it, gives it an oriental vibe right at the end, that very last note. Beautiful note, that last one, gorgeous. Let's check this out live. I really want to hear how they would do live. There was a 2017 performance. I didn't even realize that they were still performing. All right, System of a Down 2017 live. Let's check this out, Aerials. Never got to see them live, but I can imagine they are an incredible band live. They still got the same look, just with a little more gray. Okay, beautiful buildup, amazing. That vocal fell flat, definitely fell flat. Let's hear if we could pick it up. Lost a little bit of that robust roundness that's in the original. I don't know if that's just now in 2017 or, I mean, not now, obviously it's 2020 now, but like, is it more recent? Not sure, but just an interesting observation. Just observing as we go, not critiquing. Don't mean this to offend Serge at all. Just trying to understand what's going on here. It also sounds like the rhythm is a little bit rushed for his vocal. They're moving really, really quickly, but the pitch has definitely significantly improved here. It's losing a little bit of that vibe that the original has because it's slowed down. It's got more of this haunting, beautiful, haunting vibe that isn't quite here in my observation. So I'm not sure if it's just the recording here or if it is the sound problem for this performance altogether. The vocal is not high enough in the mix. For sure, all the instruments are way too high and it almost sounds like they're singing in a hallway. It's not the best sound. Love that the fans are singing along with them. It's amazing. Interesting choice. Okay, so he definitely changed it up there. I like that he was ambitious and that he tried to change it up. There's a little bit of a lack of smoothness to it. Could have been done a little bit smoother. It almost sounded like it was off the cuff as opposed to pre-planned and executed with foreknowledge. That's the vibe I'm getting from that. But with a little bit of pre-planning, that run could have been amazing. It lost a little bit, you know what it is? It's that lowered larynx position. So he's keeping it more in that higher larynx position the whole entire time. I always wanna play, but you never wanna lose. Like, it's just not going to that. Always wanna play, but you never wanna lose. Never going to that lowered larynx position. That's my assessment here. Nice. Good harmonies coming in there. I would definitely bring the guitarist's vocal up a little higher. There we go.
In the sky, when you lose one.
There, now he's getting into that vibe. That's where the song should have started. Didn't quite. Exactly like the record right there. Great ending. Great ending. They really pulled it together for the end. The beginning was just a little bit, needed a little bit of fine tuning, let's say. So I hope you guys liked this video. If you did, please hit the like button down below if you want to see more videos like this. Check out that one right there. You're gonna like it. Click it, click it, click it, click it.